And so, unfortunately, Zimbabwe and justice don't yet share the same alphabet. Unlike us. God, we're so lucky. We must really give the ANC credit for so many things. They promised houses, and they gave us houses and water and electricity, not always in the same place, but they gave it. And now we have this incredible system of justice, which is so unique that people come from all over the world to study it. It is sometimes beyond description. For example, recently somebody was fined 1,000 rand for not having a TV license. At the same time, somebody was given 500 rand bail having been found guilty of murder. Which means that if the TV inspector comes to your house, it'll save you 500 rand. The trouble with democracy is that things change, and because things change, I keep losing my chorus line. I lost Winnie. I hope Winnie will be back within reason. But my saddest loss was my butch drag, the real butch drag that I've done since 1980. Pik Buerta was even in my chorus line in 1994. He was then still in the government of national unity. He was Minister of Minerals and Energy Affairs. But being Pik, he started mixing his minerals and losing his energy. And so he eventually retired from politics and even joined the ANC, which made him useless for the chorus line. Until last year, when something really incredible happened. On the 13th of December, they found Saddam Hussein down the hole in Iraq. And the next morning, I saw the burger, and I saw the front page of the burger, and I didn't read what the burger wrote. I just looked at the pictures. And the more I looked at the pictures, the more I realized, Pik Buerta's back! And I think he's drinking again! So the butch drag. Oh, muckies. You know, when you do butch drag, you must start off by thinking thick. Ja, ek kan fully ballas begin groei, net sulke ballas, net sulke ballas. Butch ballas, né? Butch ballas. And then of course, Pik's broederbond moustache.
Let me state here most categorically. I was not down the hole in Baghdad. Saddam Hussein was down the hole. How could I have been down the hole? I wasn't even in Iraq. The fact that I was planning to go to Baghdad is irrelevant. The fact that I looked in the mirror one day and realized that with a bit of help I could look just like Saddam Hussein has got nothing to do with it. Yes. Yes, I was planning to go to Iraq as a decoy and lead the American forces into Syria and make fools of them. But then I heard that Winnie Madikizela Mandela had offered to become a human shield in Baghdad. And so I decided not to go. If that was not an invitation for blanket bombing, I don't know. So don't blame me for looking like Saddam Hussein. Blame Saddam Hussein for looking like me. In fact, they now say all the men in Baghdad are Pik Buerta lookalikes. And that's my first point. My second point is this. President George W. Bush and his British assistant are wrong. Regime change does not happen from without, it happens from within. Look at Gorbachev and Perestroika, F.W. de Klerk and Pretoria Stroika. We needed the leader of the National Party to destroy the National Party. And de Klerk did it over a weekend. And so out with the old and in with the new. And so for the sake of clarity, let me just underline. The old National Party was responsible for apartheid. The new National Party is responsible for Martinus van Schalkwyk. And if you'd looked into your crystal ball 20 years ago and told me that in the election of 2004, the once mighty powerful National Party could not even get 2% of the national vote, I would have laughed at you and put you down a hole. But as you know, we never put people down holes. We put them on islands in solitary confinement, or kept them on the 12th floor of buildings so they could easily slip on the soap in the shower and fall out of the window. And so here we are, it is Thabo Mbeki's 2004, 10 years after Nelson Mandela's 1994, 20 years after George Orwell's 1984. And the fact that we can discuss anything under the sun without the shadow of legalized racism over us is a reason to celebrate. And if I had a drink, I would celebrate, but as you know, I'm still down that hole. But then, You might be asking yourself, as you should, what is my contribution here tonight? Me, an old dinosaur from a bygone barbarian age. It's simply this. To say to you who were there with me, tell the young people who know nothing. Tell the children who know nothing. The grandchildren who know nothing. Tell them. Tell them how easily we killed. How easily we maimed, slaughtered, humiliated. How easily we lied, cheated, and stole, all in the name of Christianity, all in the name of civilization. And the only reason we in the National Party got away with it for so long is because decent, good people were too frightened to say no. But that does not mean that we whites must sit in designer sackcloth and ashes for the rest of time. We the whites, in particular, I the Afrikaner, can use my experience as a South African to play a meaningful role in the future of our democracy. So this is what I say to you. Play the role. Get out of the hole. There's no future in the hole. I know. And because I know, I'm telling you what I know. And now you know exactly what I know. And because you now know what I know, you know that all you have to say is no. Say no, I'm proudly South African. I'm an optimist, not a pessimist. My glass is always half full, never half empty. Nasdarovia.